In this video, we'll learn how to compile and run C code right from Notepad++. So here is a basic hello world.c, and I'm going to demonstrate compile and run. And right here, it just created an executable, and it also ran right from Notepad++. So let's get started. You'll require two things. One is you will need to install MinGW, which is a minimalistic GNU for Windows. And then you will also need NPP exec or executive plugin for Notepad++. So let's get started. First, you will need to install MinGW. So let's go to Google and just search for MinGW. And usually it shows up right on the top. So I'm going to click on that. And actually it's the other one, second one, SourceForge. And so click downloads. All right, and so now you can install it. Just follow the installation. So next, it is going to install this particular software in C drive, and MinGW. So continue, and this is going to take just a little bit of time. So we'll just wait till it gets over. All right, so it is done installing. So we'll click continue. And now the basic MinGW is installed, but we still need to install the C compiler and C++ compiler if you would like to try that as well. By the way, I'm also going to link how you can set up Notepad++ for C++ code also, so make sure you check that. And so let's go ahead and select all of these. Sometimes it does take a little bit of time, so you just basically pick everything. If you are not doing a Fortran program, you don't need to select that, but let's pick C++. And then Objective-C is also, we don't need that. So once you select all these four or five checkboxes, go to installation and apply changes, and that will make sure that all of these packages will be installed. So click apply changes and apply. And again, it'll take a little bit of time, so I'm going to pause the video. All right, so this step does take a little bit of time, so be patient, let it do its thing. But once it's done, it'll say that you can close the dialog, so we will close this. And now we have installed the C compiler that we will need. So you can close that. All right, so now that we have installed MinGW, we need to do one more important step. And if you miss this step, this compiling will not work. And so this step is to set up environment variable so that a command prompt or Notepad++ can find the C compiler that we just installed. Now, if you recall, we installed MinGW in C drive and MinGW. And if you go to the bin directory, this is where all the executables are located that is required. And the one that we would be using is gcc.exe. All right. So in order to set up environment variable, you need to just go to the start menu and then just search for environment variable and go to edit the system variable. Now you will need admin rights for that. So if you don't have admin rights, this may not work, but click on that and then click on environment variable right here. So click on that. And now we need to add a path under system variables. And so click on the path and click edit. And I have already added this, so let me close this. Let's create a new environment variable. So click new. And then here we need to give the path where all those MinGW executables are located. So I'm going to go here, click on this, click copy, and come back here and then click new and right click and paste. And so this will allow Windows command prompt and other application to find those gcc.executable and other application. So click OK. And now we have installed, click OK again and OK. So now we have set up the GCC, and one way to check actually is to open a command prompt. And if you just type GCC, it should give you this, basically it should be able to find your application. In fact, you can find the version. You can type GCC and then -- version, and it will tell you what version of GCC or MinGW is installed. All right. So that now that we can see this, that means that Notepad++ should be able to find that. All right. So the next step is to install NPP executable plugin. So go to plugins and plugin admin and just search for NPP exec, and it should show up right away. So I'm going to select that. By the way, if you want to learn more about it, you can go to this GitHub site and read about it. So I'm going to say install. Yes. And then it'll restart Notepad++. All right, so now we have installed NPP exec Notepad++ plugin. And so we need to set up a C compiler for that. So in order to do that, we need to go to plugins, go to NPP exec, and click on execute. Right? And here we are going to basically copy and paste this particular code or script to tell Notepad++ how to compile a C code. All right, so I'll go here. Sorry, I need to copy. In fact, you don't need all this thing. You can just type A here. And so, or whatever the name of the application will be. So I'm going to copy this, go to plugins, go to NPP exec, execute, and then just paste right here. And then click save. And I'm going to call this C compiler and click save. So we just created a script that we can execute. So click OK. Okay, so now that we have installed NPP exec and also installed the script, we need to make sure that it shows up as a menu item here. And so in order to do so, you need to go to advanced options. And now we are going to add an information to add a menu item. So here is it's asking what will be the menu item name. So you can give anything. You can say run C code or whatever you want. And then you want to also associate the script that it should run when you click on that menu item. So in our case, it is this one, C compiler. Just ignore this one because that was probably the last time I tried. So click C compiler and click add right here. And it just added a menu item. And so I'm going to click OK. And it needs to be restarted. So click OK, close, and reopen. And now if I go to plugins, NPP exec, you can see that we have this menu item. All right, so now, so far we have seen how we can set up MinGW, we install NPP exec, we set up an environment variable, and we also created a script and a menu item. So now finally, let's see if we can actually run C code. Now before we continue, let me just quickly bring up my channel. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. I post new videos every week. And there are a number of playlists and a lot of videos that you can use to learn about Notepad++. And so please make sure to click subscribe button and check the bell icon to get the notification. All right, so let's continue. So go to this very simple and basic C code. All it does is just writes hello world on the console window. So it's a very basic C code. So let's see if we can run it. So we need to go to plugins, go to NPP exec, and just click run C code. All right, so there you go. We actually just created and actually compile and run our first C code in Notepad++. You can see that this was the output because this also works as a console window. And you can actually see right here, I just created an executable a.exe. Now, if you recall it, it was right here that we were calling that or calling that C code as, okay? And so with this setup, you can run any C code and run and compile that right from Notepad++ from plugins and NPP exec and right here. Now, a few more suggestions. One is if you have a spaces in your folder or folder name or file name, try to avoid those because that can cause issue. And so try to avoid any spaces in the file name or a folder name where you have your C code. And usually it is a best practice not to have the space. The other suggestion is also that you can set up a keyboard shortcut to the menu item that you just created. So currently, in order to run this, we have to go right here, right? But we can actually set up a keyboard shortcut. So once you make changes, you can just with a keyboard shortcut, you can compile that. So let's see how we can do that. So in order to set up a keyboard shortcut for the C compiler that we just created, you need to go to run and click on modify shortcut right here. And now go to plugins tab. And this is where all your plugin information is there. So there's a lot to look at. So we want to narrow it down. So I'm going to call it run. And if you remember, I named it run C code. So it showed up right here. And so in order to create a new shortcut, click modify. And here you can actually just create your own shortcut. So maybe control alt shift. And I'm going to say, you know, one. Now, you need to be a little careful when you set it up. Don't make it so simple that it's already been used by some other keyboard shortcut and you don't want to break that. So make it a little, make sure that you don't override some default ones. So I'm going to just say Control Alt Shift 1, click OK. And you can see it just created the shortcut. Click Close. And now if I want to run that, I don't even need to go there. I can press Control Shift Alt and 1. And there you go, it just ran it, as you can see. I'm going to delete this. And let's see if it can run. So Control Shift Alt 1. And there you go. So we just learned how to compile C code and run C code right from Notepad++. Now I'm also going to just link some of the other videos where you can compile C++ code and Java code throughout this video. So make sure that you check that. Those links will be mostly on the top right corner. And I'm also going to post some other Notepad++ tips and tricks. So make sure you check those. And finally, if you like this video, please click like button. And please subscribe to my channel to get more videos like that. Thank you for watching.